Hello and welcome to beautiful Austin, Texas, the Circuit of the Americas, at round three of the MotoGP World Championship, but more importantly, round three of MotoGP Guru. My name is Jack Appleyard. I'm joined by two pretenders in Matt Burt and Elliot York, who'll be looking to beat me this weekend, as well as our expert guru back home, Nick Harris, and a very special guest, which we'll talk about in just a moment. But first, gents, let's touch on what a disaster Argentina was. The rain wreaked havoc. Nil pois for me, nil pois for you, and nil pois for you. Bertie, it couldn't have gone any worse.
An absolute shocker for all of us. The good news is we're still beating Nick Harris. That's the most important thing. Yeah, I didn't see Pecco Bagnaia having his problems. I picked Pecco big time after his double in Portugal. But yeah, it all went horribly wrong. No point, still can't believe it.
I know, disaster. Same for you, Elliot. I guess the good thing for me is I did say that Brad Binder was going to finish third in the GP, so I kind of predicted maybe that he was going to win the sprint.
No? Mate. Okay. I'm not going to give you that, mate. Yeah, what Bertie said, an absolute disaster. I went all in on Aprilia and I didn't turn out very well. They looked good in Friday free practice, but yeah, qualifying and the sprint and the race didn't work out, so yeah, just an unmitigated disaster.
But the good news is we can move on. 2 weeks later, full focus now on the Circuit of the Americas. Here, you'll be hearing our predictions very soon. You've just seen the league table there. The good news for us is we're still 10 points clear of Nick Harris. Comes as no surprise. You'll hear his predictions very shortly. A few wild card picks in there. More on that later. I think maybe someone needs to go and check that Nick's okay, having heard what he's going for. But before that, guys, this is quite a special one. Joining us on MotoGP Guru for this week and in the future as well, five times world champion Jorge Lorenzo is going to be giving us his predictions. So first off, let's hear, Jorge, what you think is going to happen here this weekend in Austin.
Hello guys, how are you? I hope you are doing great. This time for the Circuit of the Americas, I will need to be the guru, so make my prediction for pole position, sprint race, and also the complete race. So normally, playing with my friends, I'm quite good making predictions for the winner, but this time it's gonna be difficult because I will have to predict seven places. And today, how it's going in the MotoGP is really, really difficult. But I'm brave, I'm gonna try. So for the pole position, I think, even if it's quite risky, Maverick Viñales will make the pole positions because Austin is one of his favorite tracks already from the 2017, when he was really, really quick with the Yamaha and has been always one of the favorite tracks for Maverick. He will be the winner, I think, for the sprint race, because when he is very convinced, he's able to be really, really competitive and constant. Second place will be for Bezzecchi, third place for Martin, who is also very explosive for the sprint race. And for the complete race, I believe Maverick will be the double win. Bagnaia, who is very quick in the long distance, will finish second. And I'm gonna risk with Quartararo, because he's been always quick in Austin track, and he has a very good second part of the races.
I mean, I'm not going to lie, guys, it's pretty difficult to argue against a man that's won five world championships, but Maverick Viñales, pole position, sprint win and Grand Prix win, Top Gun to do the hat trick. Can you see that happening?
I can't actually, Jack. No, nothing against Jorge Lorenzo, but that is a bold with a capital B. I think if you go gambling with Lorenzo in Vegas, you wouldn't be hanging on to your house for too long with those kind of predictions, but who knows? He's a smart cookie, you saw, hey, but that is bold in the extreme for me. The Viñales lockout, sorry Jorge, can't see it.
I mean, he was strong in Portugal, Elliot, and strong on Friday in Argentina, but it all faded from there. Can you see that?
I can't honestly see that, no, because there is also a threat of rain this weekend, and obviously that's what destroyed their weekend last time out in Argentina. I mean, I went full force on Aprilia, so I wasn't going to do it again this weekend. So, I mean, brave from Jorge. Like you say, you can't really argue with a five-time world champion, but yeah, I'm not feeling that at all.
Well, let's see. Jorge Lorenzo has got his predictions in. Now let's hear from our expert guru, or so-called expert guru, Nick Harris. 10 points adrift of us. He's got a little bit of catching up to do. So Nick, what do you think is going to go down this weekend?
Well, lads, we've got another expert in now, haven't we, eh? Jorge Lorenzo, you are in for a tough time because you got two experts against you now. Argentina wasn't easy, though, was it, with the weather and injuries and everything else? So not so many points for anybody. Right, here we go. Here are my predictions. Pole position, Jorge Martin, former Moto3 winner, having a really good season. The sprint race. I'm going for Bagnaia. Yeah, he had a tough old time in Argentina. I think he'll fight back. Zecchi in second place. What a ride by him in the rain. We don't know what the weather's going to be like in America. And I'm going Alex Marquez. Yeah, Alex Marquez in third place. He's third in the race in Argentina. And what a season he is having. Okay. I know you lads aren't very brave. You're not going to stick your necks out. You're not going to do something. You're going for the old favourites. I'm not, because I'm brave. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go for Johann Zarco to score his first ever Grand Prix win and win the race in Texas. In second place, I'm going for Bezzecchi. And in third place, Maverick Vinales. Had a tough old time on the Aprilia in Argentina, but he was in tremendous form, wasn't he, in Portugal. So, lads, got Hoy on my side now. Can you be brave or are you going to be boring? You're going to stick your necks out? Well, let's wait and see. I have, and my predictions are going to be correct.
Well, we've come to the top of the famous tower here in Cota just to illustrate A, how high above Nick Harris we're going to be come the end of the season, and how much looking down we're going to be doing on our so-called expert guru, especially after a set of predictions like that. Johann Zarco, a man that has never won a MotoGP race, is apparently going to finally do it this weekend. I mean, where's he got that from?
Johann, you know I love you, you know I respect you, but if that prediction comes correct here on Sunday, I'm backflipping off the bar in the hotel on Sunday night, because that's out of left field, that one. But who knows? Harry is supposed to be the official MotoGP guru.
So he says. I mean, we are in Austin, Texas. Can somebody just go check that Nick hasn't been putting some bourbon in his coffee this morning? I don't know where he's got that one from, Elliot.
I mean, it's brave. It's brave, to say the least. But yeah, I don't think it's going to come off. Obviously, he had a good weekend in Argentina and in Portimao, but I just can't see Zarco winning.
I'm feeling confident that 10-point lead is going to be intact and probably grow by the time we get to Sunday night. And I'm confident because these are going to be our predictions. So we're going to do it slightly differently because it's the three of us. We're going to split it up. I'll tell you what I think will be pole position. Elliot will give us the top three in the sprint, and Bertie will finish us off with the top three in the Grand Prix. Nice and easy for me. Any arguments with this, guys? I'm going to go Jorge Martin, pole position. I think that's a pretty easy one.
Absolutely rock solid. No argument from me on that one, Jack. Pole position here last year. He's the king of qualifying in so many occasions. Yeah, Martin for me for pole.
Nice and easy. Glad we're all in agreement. Elliot, top three in the sprint. What are you going for?
Yeah, so I think Martin's due pole position. I think he's due a sprint win as well. So I'm going Martin to finish first in the sprint. World Championship leader Bezzecchi to finish second. Now, it's going to be a dogfight out there, I think. Ducati locked out the top five last year in qualifying, so I'm going to go for a Ducati top three and Bagnaia to finish on the podium in third in the sprint. I think that's pretty solid.
Tough to disagree with that either. I've gone for Martin sprint win, Bezzecchi second, Bagnaia third. I like that one, mate.
Thank you, mate.
For the GP, Bertie, what are you going for?
For the GP, I mean, I know Nick Harris said it was going to be boring, but it's points that make prizes, Harry, in this game. Pekka Bagnaia for the race win for me, ahead of Marco Bezzecchi, who looked so, so good all weekend in Termas, coming in this weekend as the world championship leader. And another all-Ducati lockout of the podium, Jorge Martin, who is my pole man with these boys. I think he'll complete an all-Ducati podium here on Sunday. Fingers crossed. Come on, Team Bertie.
Let's see how we all get on. Of course, you can head to MotoGPGuru.com to put your predictions in, to check out what us three, Nick Harris, Jorge Lorenzo, have put down in full as well. And don't forget that we're playing for a Ducati Panigale V4S here, guys. So the stakes are high. Make sure you get involved. we've gone for pretty much Ducati domination this weekend. Nick Harris, wild card pick. Johann Zarco to finally do it here this weekend. And get this, Jorge Lorenzo, the five-time world champion, he thinks we're going to see a Maverick Vinales hat-trick. We'll find out on Sunday night. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll see you in 2 weeks' time in Jerez. And as I said, get on MotoGPGuru.com and get your predictions in now at a round three of the MotoGP World Championship, the Red Bull Grand Prix of the Americas. Enjoy it.